to this new edition of Wednesday Night Dropzone. This will be our opening contest, and it will be a 10-man battle royale to see who will become the number one contender for the West Coast title and who will face the Dictator at Winter Wonder Ball. Of course, Winter Wonder Ball will be our Christmas theme event, so definitely look forward to that this Christmas. Right now is one of our newest wrestlers, who's part of our new talent. I'm not sure what exactly we call it, a new talent outlook, talent program. It's one of those two. That was Mike DeLawrence, who just first came out, and here's one half of America's most hated, the player, Will Jones. Will Jones, just like his tag team partner, hopes to showcase that he is capable of being as a singles competitor, also as a tag team competitor. He wants to try to do what his tag team partner, superstar Chris Mole, did at Great Frontier and compete with a chance to try to go after a singles title here in the NGWF. Of course, America's Most Hated have tried their hand in trying to win the tag team titles before. That was back in the Dawn of Destruction. It was running rampant all over NGWF. Back, NGWF is still owned by Achilles Heel, but that doesn't really matter in this matchup at the moment. Right now, Mike the Law and Will Jones are locking up. As I've stated before, this is a battle royale, or as some people might call it, a royal rumble. Either way you say it is absolutely correct. The objective is, overall, is just to throw your opponent off top of the rope. Both feet have to hit the floor, and once they do, that person will be eliminated. As I've stated before, this is for the number one contendership for the West Coast title. The Dictator, of course, won that title at the Great Frontier, beating Mr. Jabba, Solberg, and El Caballero Verde. And here comes out another new wrestler who goes by the name of Triple J. Of course, Triple J's real name is Joey Jacob Johns. Interesting name, if you ask me. All of them sound like first names. Anyway, Triple J, you know, I've seen this guy in action, and he's not bad. In fact, with a little bit of tweaking here and there, I think Triple J may actually be a force to reckon with here in the NGWF. But like all great talent, he's got to showcase it. He's got to, you know, learn to take the ball and run with it. He's got to learn. Oh, Mike DeLawrence has been eliminated. And here comes out Solberg, who was recently hired by the other co-owner of the NGWF. Solberg, of course, is from SCWF. Now, what I was trying to get at with Triple J, okay, what I was trying to say is that before you can become a big star in the NGWF, you kind of have to, you have to prove yourself. You have to kind of pave the way, so to speak. You have to you have to come out here every single night and give it 110%. Hell, even go a little further, 112%. That's the only way people are even going to notice you. Because you're not, you know, there's a good chance that you can not be on Dropzone for 2 weeks straight. So if you don't bring your A game when you get the chance to be on the main show, which is Dropzone here, you know, you got to do what you can to get noticed. As we all know, wrestling fans do sometimes have a bit of a short attention span. But El Caballero Verde has anything but a short attention span. As this guy has competed for the West Coast Championship. This El Caballero Verde has fought the likes of the Rapture, Iroquois, and Dictator. This guy has all the makings, has all the tools necessary to become a big deal here in the NGWF. He just has to start picking up some wins. That's all he has to do. Oh, big boots like that. I could definitely see him racking up the W's. Now Cabario Verde is going after Solberg. Of course, these two fought in a fatal four-way match at the Great Frontier with a West Coast title. And here comes out Nakamaru, who, of course, was at the Great Frontier as well. He was in the six-man matchup for the Rage Championship. Of course, Keogh ended up winning that. OJ will get his rematch clause here tonight. Should be a very interesting time for both Keogh and OJ. Oh! Well, let's focus on this match for now. And now El Caballo Verde. Oh, it's just... Right now, he's just in complete control of Solberg. I think Solberg has yet to adapt to the aggressive nature of NGWF. He has yet to adapt to the fact that in the NGWF, there is no disqualifications, unlike Sin City Blitz. Here, anything goes. Oh, it's a completely different atmosphere than what Solberg's used to. And wait a minute! Wait a minute! That looks like... That kind of looks like Lucius Caesar, but... That's Lucius Caesar, but he... He's donned his... The look that he had when he first debuted in the NGWF back in January. That is a very interesting turn of events. Ever since he lost to the Rapture, looks like Caesar just cut all ties with Jezio Duel. But decided to go his own way. And even dye his hair gray. To even look like Caesar. See if it's gonna do him any. Oh man! I don't think coloring your hair gray really does anything to make you a better wrestler. But Caesar has always been an incredible talent here in the NGWF. He's a former core champion. He's the only one in that ring right now who actually has won a title. So it's not to say. Oh, it's not to say that Caesar is not some pushover. I mean, he has a better chance of winning this than anyone. Even Solberg. Nakamaru going after Will Jones. Caballo and Triple J going head-to-head. Looks like Triple J is getting ahead of El Caballo. And Solberg has been eliminated. Jay now is trying to eliminate El Caballo Verde, and he nearly almost does. El Caballo Verde is hanging on, and he's right back in this match. Caesar now going after Nakamaru. Now El Caballo, okay, it looks like they both had the same mindset. Of course, in these type of matches, alliances are very fragile. Everyone against everyone. Nakamaru now going after Caesar and a Hurricanrana! El Caballo Verde trying to get out Triple J. Will he succeed? And he does! Triple J has been eliminated from this match. El Caballo Verde now going after player Will Jones. Nakamaru going after Caesar. And now Caesar going after El Caballo. Of course, Caesar and El Caballo. they faced each other before. Let's see who will be the better man here. And a belly to belly from El Caballo Verde. And here comes out All-American Skull. Oh, electric chair drop. All-American Skull, of course, has been a part of NGWF since 2006. So so he could be considered a veteran. Oh! All American Skull is a former tag team champion. So he's yet another person in this match who actually has won a title. Oh! Motto is just right now in complete... Whoa, he was in complete control of Caesar, but Caesar knocks him out! Nakamaru has been eliminated. That's unfortunate. Right now, Caesar and All-American Score going at it, and player Will Jones has been eliminated from El Caballo. Here we go! Chris Moll, the superstar, coming down to the ring, hoping to pick up where his tag team partner left off. This could be a big-time match for Chris Moll. In fact, it could be a big-time match for any one of these incredible, incredible wrestlers. Wait a minute. Chris Moll trying to get out of El Caballo. Caesar's trying to get out of All-American Skull. Will we see an elimination? All-American Skull's hanging on, and El Caballo's hanging on. No one got eliminated, but it was definitely a close call. Oh, flips him down. Now Chris Moll once again trying to eliminate El Caballo, and a suplex from Caesar. So far, Caesar is in control of All-American Skull, big time chop. Caballo and Chris Moll locking up. Looks like Chris Moll is trying to get... Oh, wait, no. Caballo reverses it, and here comes out the most charismatic man in the universe, Mr. Jabba. Of course, Mr. Jabba made his debut here in the NGWF before going to Sin City Blitz, then comes right back home to the NGWF. This could be another huge opportunity for Mr. Jabba. Oh, man. Beautiful move there from Mr. Jabba. Right now, Mr. Jabba now going after All-American Skull. And All-American Skull whips Mr. Jabba into the turnbuckle, but no, Jabba reverses it. Who will face the Dictator at Winter Wonder Ball for the West Coast Championship? I don't know, but I don't even have a favorite in this match. All of these incredible wrestlers both have an equal opportunity. All of them, I think, are worthy of facing the Dictator. Oh, here we go. Caesar just showcasing that the vicious maneuvers we have grown so accustomed to seeing. And El Caballo now trying to eliminate Chris Moll. Will he succeed? Well, Caesar's going to try to eliminate All-American Skull. Mr. Jabba is just standing idly by. And, oh, incredible move from Mr. Jabba. Mr. Jabba, like Caesar, is a former core champion. Of course, he only had that core championship for a week. Caesar held it for 3 months. Back when he had the Elite on his side. Of course, Mr. Jabba was a part of the Elite. So, this should be interesting, as these two former team members will be at each other's throats eventually. And now Mr. Jabba is trying to eliminate the superstar Chris Moll. El Caballo Verde now going right over to Caesar. All-American Skull is going to try to eliminate... Wait a minute, Chris Moll has been eliminated. Will Caesar join him? No, he will not. And... Oh, power slam. Vicious maneuver there from Mr. Jabba, showcasing his incredible strength. Wait a minute. Caballo. Oh, he's trying to go for a maneuver there, but Jabba just reversed it. Now he's in control. He's going to try to eliminate El Caballo Verde. Will he succeed? No, El Caballo's still in this. Oh, Mr. Jamba's right back at it again. And Caballo's been eliminated. Looks like it's now down to Caesar, All-American Skull, Mr. Jabba. Oh, huge slap from Mr. Jabba. Now Caesar and Jabba are at each other's throats. It's going to happen here, and Caesar eliminates Mr. Jabba. We are now down to Caesar and All-American Skull. Who will go to Winter Wonder Ball? Who's gonna get an early Christmas present? And by Christmas present, I mean a title shot. Oh, American Skull. He was in control, but now the two are staring each other down. Should be an interesting one-on-one competition. There we go, Caesar. Oh, spinning neckbreaker. Methodically and brutally wearing down All-American Skull, but All-American Skull fights back with a backbreaker. Caesar now, he grabs All-American Skull, whips him. Oh, European uppercut. And the last two, who is going? So far, this has been an incredible turn of events. So far, this has been absolutely interesting. And Russian leg sweep. Whips him. And wait a minute. Here we go. All-American Skull. He can. Yes, he eliminates Caesar. And he will become the number one contender for the West Coast Championship. And he will face Finn Dictator this Christmas. Congratulations, All-American Skull. Definitely a hard-earned victory. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our second match, and it will be between Jayden and a new woman wrestler, I should say, Mikallica. Of course, Mikallica made her debut back in the Great Frontier. She went up against Clara Drool in a rather quick match. Jayden here, no doubt, will probably give her a bit of more of a handful, as Jayden... Jayden's a bit of a powerhouse, actually. Very tough woman. She actually fought against Crazy Cheyenne in an Extreme Rules match, and those two just tore the house down. Of course, Jayden ended up getting the victory. Let's see what Jayden has in store for this small town girl, Mikallica. As I mentioned before, Mikallica is half Hispanic and half Alaskan Native American. Comes from a very small town on the border of Alaska and Canada. Rather obscure little town. Not entirely sure of the name of it. No one's giving me these damn notes, so I can't exactly give you the information. It's like this place is a top secret town or something. It's classified. Apparently. All I know is it's a small town of like less than 500 people, but you wouldn't know that from her attitude. She's all fired up. Hopefully Jayden is prepared for Mikallica here. You know what? I have something very interesting to point out here. Now, it says in her bio, Mikallica's bio, for that matter. I'll get to Jayden here in a minute. But Mikallica, there's something really strange about it. Okay, half Hispanic, half Alaskan Native American. Now, you don't hear about that every day. You know, normally, the stereotype, right, is that Hispanic people don't like the cold. Which is not always true, but bear with me for a minute here. So, at some point, okay, her parents met, moved to Alaska, and gave birth to, oh, a woman who can do incredible body splashes off the top rope. Well, sure, why not? I guess it's just something interesting to point out. You just don't hear about that every day. The strange mixes of people. Wait a minute. And what the hell that was? Some sort of top rope jawbreaker? Now, as I mentioned before, Jayden, of course, is from England. But wait a minute. Okay, apparently I'm not even going to get around to talking about Jayden. One, two, three. And once again, Mikallica picking up a really quick victory. Wow. Well, okay then. This is the second time in a row now. Mikallica has just come out here and just dominated an opponent. I really thought Jayden was going to take it to a limit, but shame on me for thinking that. Tombstone pile driver, and that was just the end of it right there. Well, that's unfortunate. I'm going to actually spill some information about Jayden. I guess we'll just have to wait until next time she shows up on Dropzone. Mikallica now celebrating yet another victory. Congratulations, Mikallica. I expect big things from her in the future. And here we go with our Rage title match. It will be between Keogh and OJ. Of course, Keogh won the Rage Championship at the Great Frontier in a six-man elimination matchup. Incredible victory for this guy. When Keogh first came on the scene here, he wasn't doing that terribly well. And I guess he just needed a good kick in the arse. Because that's what Irish people say. They don't say ass, they say arse. I guess it makes it sound better. I don't know. Anyway, it doesn't matter. What happened is that Keogh just brought a whole new level of intensity. A whole new level of just an extreme attitude. Just aggression. He brought it in here to the NGWF. He brought it into that match. And became the new Rage Champion. Congratulations for Keogh. But he's going to have one hell of a match with here with OJ. I mean, OJ here is one of our most decorated champions. I mean, this guy has accomplished so much in the NGWF in so little time. Here, let me tell you what OJ has accomplished. He's a three-time core champion, a two-time West Coast champion, a lightweight champion, and is a former Rage champion. In fact, he's getting his rematch for the Rage Championship here tonight. OJ has also fought against the likes of Strife, Rapture, Hardcore Eats, Mystic Ninja, Mad Dog, The Wolf. You name anyone in NGWF, and he's probably fought against them at least once. Or at least passed by them, smack-talked them, whatever. OJ has done it, pretty much done everything here in the NGWF. And he's hoping to become a two-time Rage Champion by beating Keogh, who is one of our newer wrestlers. I mean, you wouldn't think that watching this guy's matches, you wouldn't think that Keogh is a new wrestler. Because it's just the way he just carries himself. He carries himself like a champion. He carries himself like a true competitor. But the interesting thing to point out is that Keogh... Keogh loves really two things in life. Drinking and fighting. When he's not fighting, he's drinking. And when he's not drinking, he's fighting. Sometimes it is a combination of both. It's just... I guess for some reason he just feels compelled to do what apparently what every Irishman loves to do. Apparently. Oh, but OJ's gotta take advantage of the fact that, oh, Keogh is a rookie. He's gotta take advantage of Keogh has very little experience in the extreme attitude of NGWF. And wait a minute. Oh, but Keogh seems to be holding his own against OJ. Oh! Now this match is extreme rules. Oh, meaning these wrestlers can do anything they want to one another in order to win this match. And for all those people out there who are very little in your thinking when someone says they can do whatever they want to each other in a match, well, usually when an extreme rules match applies, again, I gotta tell you this for all those extremely little people out there. Usually, extreme rules matches means there is no disqualification. Weapons are not only allowed, but they're welcomed. That's a reference to something. I'll tell you guys later. Anyway, weapons, you know, any type of weapon you can bring to the NGWF. Oh, in these types of matches, it's perfectly okay. Now you might say, well, Mr. Dragon, would it be okay to shoot somebody? Well, of course not, because that would be considered assault. But here, oh, tables, kendo sticks, chairs, ladders, guitars. Those are the type of weapons. Oh, that came so close. So close to hitting OJ in the back of the head, and OJ's just taking the fight right to Keogh. Those, like I said, those types of weapons are usually what you'll see in an extreme rules match. Also, in extreme rules matches, it's false count anywhere. Wait a minute, Keogh! There we go! He's drinking and fighting, taking a beer from one of the fans. Drinking it, apparently he didn't particularly care for the taste of it, and just spit it right in OJ's face. Maybe now he's climbing up. Oh, double axe handle, and OJ gets knocked down to the ground. Keogh's got to try to go for a weapon, but no, OJ stops him and throws him right back into the ring. Of course, OJ thrives on these types of matches. He made a career off these types of matches. In fact, his very first match in the NGWF, he won the core championship against a NGWF original, Insane Man, back in 2006. And that match was, well, Extreme Rules, and oh! Very unique variation of a backbreaker. Bounce him off the ropes, and up, oh, knee to the face. He was just brutally taking the fight right to OJ, name it. Now, OJ now taking the fight to Keogh. Should I go for a drop kick, but Keogh just gets out of the way. Oh, man. Now he's got him in submission maneuver. Will Keogh tap? Will he tap to the submission maneuver? And no, he will not. Here we go, Keogh now. Oh, gets slammed down to the ground thanks to OJ. And, oh, big knee to the face right now. Keogh is in control of the former Rage champion. Oh, wait a minute. Come on. Well, it was bound to happen. It was bound that the Spanish announce table is going to be destroyed at least once here in this drop zone. And it looks like Keogh is going to be the one who's going to put OJ through the Spanish announce table. Oh, sit down powerbomb. Will that be it? One. No. What? What? Only a one count? Sometimes I'm always surprised at how tough OJ is. Again, OJ's been in the ring with some pretty tough guys, so maybe he's just learned from the best. Oh! Now OJ's been busted wide open thanks to Keogh. He's been pretty dominant in this match. I'm really surprised. I guess Keogh's just showing that aggression that he showcased at the Great Frontier. That aggression that won him a championship. Keogh's got a lot to prove here in the NGWF, even as a Rage champion. OJ. He gets picked up. Oh, slammed down. Keogh, where's Keogh going? Keogh's going right back in the ring. Now he's going outside the ring. OJ going out to get a weapon. Wait a minute. What? He's got a sledgehammer, and Keogh looks like he's pulling out a table. Oh, smacks OJ with it. What's he gonna do here? Sets up the table. OJ now has got the sledgehammer. Oh! Wait a minute, Keogh. He's got him. He's got him right where he wants him. What's he gonna do? Oh! Just barely missed that table. He's going for a pin. One! OJ once again just getting out. A count of one and a spear! A modified spear at that. OJ looks like he's hurting. He's got this replica belt. Wait a minute. What is Keogh planning on doing here? Takes him off. Bounces off the ropes. Bashes him right in the face with his knee. Now he's calling for something. Spins him around. Picking him up. And... oh, sit down powerbomb through the table. This could be it. One, two, three. And Keogh retains the Rage Championship. Something was wrong with OJ. OJ was just not on his game here tonight because Keogh, this relatively new wrestler, just took the fight right to him almost the entire match. I mean, OJ got some offense, but boom, look at that. Then this right here, oh, sit down powerbomb right through the table, and that was the end of it. Keogh picking up a huge victory here at NGWF Drop Zone and retaining the Rage Championship. Wow. I guess OJ's got to go to the drawing board now. But Keogh, I like this guy. I see Keogh holding on to that title for quite some time. And here we go with this impromptu matchup between Gravedigger and the Rapture. As you guys saw at the very beginning of the show, the Rapture attacked Gravedigger. Of course, Gravedigger won that fight. But here, I decided to make this match official, which the other co-owner was perfectly okay with that. I still don't know who the co-owner is, by the way. If I knew, I would tell you guys, but I just don't. Uses an alias, uses one of those voice things, the mask of their voice. It's all... seems kind of weird to me, you know? Seems kind of shady. But nothing is shady about this match, let me tell you. This match is not going to be pretty. It's not going to be the fate of heart. This match is going to be bloody. It's going to be brutal. Gravedigger is known for being in matches of this caliber. He's known for putting his body, his soul, his very humanity in the line. And he's going to be putting that on the line when he faces against the former world champion. In fact, both of these two are former world champions. When the Rapture comes down here, I hope Gravedigger definitely brings his A game. I hope Gravedigger knows what he's getting himself into. Because the Rapture went on a tear for 6 months straight when he was world champion. Gravedigger, of course, is the longest reigning NGWF world champion of all time. Whoa! But unlike Rapture, he never defended the title once. Rapture defended that title successfully for 6 months straight. Finally losing the title at Apocamania to Mystic Ninja. We haven't seen or heard from Mystic Ninja since. Because his contract was up, and that was actually technically his last match, but he has not contacted the NGWF at all. So he must be really injured if he doesn't want to come back. Rapture, definitely lives up to his name. Anyone who gets in the ring with this man, they're gonna definitely get hurt. And I hope Gravedigger realizes that. Of course, Gravedigger has been in hardcore matches before. He's no stranger to them. Much like OJ, he kind of made a career out of it. He made a name for himself feuding with the Wolf back in 2006. That was for the West Coast title. It was Gravedigger's very first title here in the NGWF was indeed the West Coast Championship for the Rapture, or as he used to be called, the Bomb. His first championship was the Rage Championship. There we go, these two lock-in feuds. This right here, is a main event quality match, if I do say so myself. This match, we got two former world champions going head-to-head in an extreme rules match. No rules, no regulations. These two will beat the living hell out of one another until one just can't get up for the count of three. I'm going to enjoy this match, and I'm sure you, the NGWF fans, will enjoy this match as well. Wait a minute, Rapture going for a sleeper hold. Looks like he's trying to end this match early. Gravedigger is just not allowing that to happen. Here we go. Just smacks him down. Rapture's in complete control of Gravedigger. Here we go. Rapture now back in control. Big elbow. His fans are not liking it. Kicking it in the gut. And Gravedigger with a big club right to the neck area of the Rapture, trying to slow him down. Good luck with that. And once again, Gravedigger seems to be in control. No, Rapture comes back. Gravedigger now bounces back. This is a bit of a back and forth battle between these two. They're like caged animals is what they are. I feel sorry for the people in the arena right now. Hell, I feel sorry for myself for the fact that I am not too far away from these two. These two are going to destroy one another. It might as well bring down the entire arena along with it. Right now, we have the two most violent men in all of NGWF in a match.
And it's all because Rapture attacked Gravedigger at the very beginning of this show. Who knows what might happen in this match? But so far, these two have not gone outside the ring to get any weapons or anything. Right now, this has actually been a pretty technical match so far. Pretty uncharacteristic of these two. These two usually are known for, you know, powerhouse moves. They're known for the brawling. They're not really known for the technical prowess. Oh! Close under the back of the head, so that's what I'm talking about. That's what Rapture's really known for. He's just known for those brutal maneuvers. And wait a minute! Oh! Belly to belly! Nothing pretty about that. Right now. Wait a minute. Now Gravedigger's back in control. What's going to happen? Oh. Rapture right now. It's just going right after Gravedigger. Knocks him outside the ring. And, oh, big club back. Oh, and Gravedigger throws him down with a big old hip toss. And now they're outside the ring. What's going to happen from here? Who's going to get the advantage? Rapture's got a guitar. Looks like Gravedigger's got to get something. Oh, man. He's got a ladder. Oh, the Rapture knocks him down with that guitar. And now Rapture has got that ladder. Oh, going right after the knee of Gravedigger. Oh, no, knocks him down with a brutal, brutal hit. Right now, he's trying to get some space between him and that ladder. He doesn't want to get hit by it again. Oh, but he does anyway. Rapture now going right back after. Wait a minute. What's Rapture going to do? Rapture is going after a Singapore cane. And he's got it. Gravedigger takes it away from him. What's going to happen? Yep, now they're just fighting over it. Oh. Rapture's now back in control of this match. Oh, smashes him right over the head with that Singapore cane. Man. Oh, slams him in the announce table. I think we both buy those in bulk. Oh. These two are now outside the ring. And still. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, well, false alarm. I thought Gravedigger was going to go back in the ring. Him and Rapture are just now staring each other down as they're walking towards something. Trying to play mind games with each other, I suppose. But wait a minute, Rapture with a sleeper hold on Gravedigger. And it doesn't do anything. Rapture now throws Gravedigger right back into the ring. What's going to happen? Where's Rapture going? Rapture looks like he took a drink from one of the fans. Now he's slowly making his way to Gravedigger and throws it right in Gravedigger's face, blinding him temporarily. Oh, knocks him down with just a furious punches. Flurry of them. Now, once again, they're staring each other down. Probably trying to figure out what I have to do to get the other guy down. They're trying to go for a strike, realizing that Rapture's right there and finally strikes him down. And now he's just on the attack. And Rapture takes the crutch, throws it down. Oh, with a shoulder thrust, knocking down Gravedigger. And, oh! Absolutely vicious maneuver. Gravedigger right now with a couple punches. Rapture, what's Rapture gonna do? And a club right to the head. Oh, vicious elbows right to the shoulder and neck area. Now going after Gravedigger's arm. Gravedigger's starting to fight back. DDT! And he's going outside the ring. He's got a guitar. smashes it over Rapture's head. These two have had it. These two are just in the middle of just an incredible matchup. No matter what they do to one another, the other one just gets right back up and demands more. They've had a couple stare downs, probably trying to figure out, how do I knock this guy down? Oh, leg drop. Rapture, now Rapture taking a sweet time to get back in the ring, and now he's back in the ring, and wait a minute, here we go! This could be the end! Rapture picks him up and an Armageddon hammer! Going for the pin, one, only a one count. Gravedigger just gets right back up. Oh! Gotta do a little bit more damage than that, Rapture. Oh, wait a minute. I think Rapture actually did more damage to Gravedigger than what Gravedigger's letting on. Who was holding his rib cage? Wait a minute. Oh! Now Gravedigger with that table is just taking the fight right to him. Wait a minute. Here we go. What is Gravedigger going to do? And a... Oh, big club right to the face. Picks him up again. And throws him into the arena. Or I should say ring. Either way, he's right back in there. Now he comes right back out. And Gravedigger with the ladder. Oh, smashes him down to the ground again. Rapture going right back in the ring. Gravedigger going back in the ring. Gravedigger still got that ladder. He throws it down. Oh, what an incredible feat of strength from Gravedigger, just throwing out Rapture right outside the ring. And here we go. Here goes yet another Spanish announce table. Picks him up. Oh! Absolutely vicious maneuver! And Rapture's been busted wide open. And he is slowly getting back up. He's a little dazed and confused. I think Gravedigger knew that Rapture was just going to get right back up because these two look like they're so similar to one another. And the fact that they could take so much pain! Wait a minute, where are these two? Oh, wait a minute, now these two got some weapons. Oh, and Gravedigger gets knocked down by that replica title. And now Rapture's is just in control. Oh, eventually knocks down Gravedigger once again and is in control. Just smacking that replica title. Wait a minute, Gravedigger's now got that replica title. And, oh, knocks down. Well, almost knocks down Rapture. Rapture's been busted wide open. Oh! He's got blood all over his face. Wait a minute. What is Gravedigger gonna do here? And he tosses the Rapture right into the fans! Fans are definitely getting an interesting experience being so close to these monsters. They don't know what to do to one another. Oh! Rapture is just trying his absolute best to keep Gravedigger down, and it's the same thing with Gravedigger. He's trying his best to keep Rapture down, and every time these two try something, the other one, you know, just shrugs it off as nothing. Wait a minute, what is... Oh! Massive headbutt right to the already bleeding head of Rapture. And throws him in the steel steps. Rapture hurts his knee in the process. Now Rapture throws Gravedigger. It's gonna happen. Oh, kicks him in the gut. Oh. Oh, Gravedigger with another big headbutt. Looks like Rapture's actually starting to slow down a little bit. These two actually look like they're hurt. Wait a minute. Here we go. Oh. Rapture with a trash can right across Gravedigger. Gravedigger's going to try to get some offense going. Otherwise, Rapture is going to stay one step ahead of him. Here we go once again. And Gravedigger throws the Rapture right back in the crowd. And the crowd, while cheering on Gravedigger, were kind of keeping away from the Rapture. And that's a good thing. Throws Gravedigger right back in the match. He grabs a trash can. Now he goes right back inside the ring. These two go back outside the ring again. Looks like Rapture's now in control. He's taking out that table. Looks like he's got to hope to do some damage. Gravedigger, I think he's just toying with Rapture, trying to get some energy, trying to conserve it a little bit. What's going to happen here? Gravedigger with a big back suplex. And here we go once again. Oh! Don't know what Gravedigger calls that. I don't think he ever gave that maneuver a name. But Rapture bounces back and oh no! Oh my god! Rapture just spears him right through the barricade. That Digger looks like he is a little worse for wear. And a two-handed choke slam. Drags him right back to the ring. Oh, elbow. Wait a minute. Here we go. And a leg drop. Back inside the ring. What's going to happen here? Gravedigger now fighting back with vicious punches. Rapture now. Oh, atomic drop. There goes Gravedigger once again. Wait a minute, submission maneuver. Looks like it's a dragon sleeper. Will Gravedigger put the Rapture to sleep? I don't think so. And I will be correct. Wait a minute, Rapture with a two-handed choke slam. Going for the pin. One. Only a one count. Rapture with a few fist cuffs of his own, clothesline, and oh, huge clothesline. He's turning Gravedigger inside out and picks him up for an Argentine backbreaker. Here we go, 1, 2, and 3. The Rapture beats Gravedigger in this Extreme Rules match. Man. These two have both the Rapture and Gravedigger. This is the first time these two have ever had a one-on-one matchup here in the NGWF, and they did not disappoint. Oh, man. Rapture getting a huge win over Gravedigger. I'm sure this feud between these two is far from over. Right now, the Rapture, he is in complete control. We'll come back to the NGWF Gravedigger because I hope Gravedigger has had a good time thus far coming back, because the Rapture, well, you can consider the Rapture his welcome wagon. time, this will be our main event, and it will be the NGWF World Champion, Iroquois, and Dawn of Destruction versus the Wolfpack Legion in a six-man tag team elimination match. Now, unlike normal six-man tag team matches, this match has a stipulation, and the only way to win, well, I should say eliminate your opponent, is by doing your finishing maneuver. So, there will be no pinfalls, there will be no submissions, just straight up finishers in this match. Mercedes, on the hand, I think will go down as the most brutal and the most ruthless tag team the NGWF has ever seen. They won those tag team titles at Apocamania and have had them since. The Ghost and the Monster, the only reason why they're getting yet another tag team title shot is because the Wolf wants a rematch with Iroquois for the NGWF World Championship. However, the Iroquois said that the only way that Wolf's gonna get his rematch clause, you know, get his rematch, is if, you know, he has both Dokes and Mercedes put on the tag team titles. That way we'll have a six-man tag team match. So, I talked to the co-owner about this, and what Wolf and Iroquois want from each other, and we decided that why not just put them in an Elimination Chamber match for both the NGWF World Championship and the Tag Team titles. That's right, if Iroquois wins, or Iroquois and DOD win, DOD, Dawn of Destruction, become the new Tag Team champions. Iroquois will retain the World Championship. It, oh! Great Tag Team work there. But if a Wolfpack Legion win, the Wolf will win the NGWF World Championship, and Dokes and Mercedes will retain the tag team titles. There's also another stipulation that me and the co-owner agreed on. Of course, I was a bit reluctant about this, mind you. I did not want to go with this option, but it seemed like a safe bet because I want to try to get rid of the Wolfpack Legion. They've just been a cancer here in the NGWF. Another stipulation that will happen at this Elimination Chamber match is that whoever loses in this match will be forced to disband. Meaning, ooh, double knee slide to the face. Meaning, if DOD and Iroquois lose, those three men will never be able to team up with one another ever again. If the Wolfpack Legion lose, the Wolfpack Legion is finished. They are done. So very high stakes for the main event at Winter Wonderball. And yes, you gotta believe that it will be a main event level match. I mean, it's never been done before. And here we go, Wolf's been tossed outside the ring. Wolf there, oh, is very confident in the fact that Wolfpack Legion are gonna be victorious on Winter Wonderball. He even calls it his, that would be his Christmas present. It's to showcase why he is and forever will be the face of NGWF. Of course, it's hard to argue with Wolf when he claims that he is the best thing NGWF has going for it. He is a two-time NGWF World Champion. He's a four-time West Coast Champion, a Tag Team Champion, and a Rage Champion. Of course. Wait a minute. Here we go. Wait a minute. Mercedes could get eliminated right here, and he dies. Iroquois with that Tiger Bomb Powerbomb. Seems kind of repetitive to say that way. But he has eliminated Mercedes. Now the Wolfpack Legion are down with just the Wolf and Dokes. Wolf and Dokes have quite a task ahead of them, as this is now turned on to a 3-on-2 handicap match. As I was stating before, I mean, it's hard to argue that the Wolf is one of the best wrestlers in NGWF has to offer. Very few people in the NGWF have credentials like him. Wait a minute, here we go. Flips him over. There are no submissions in this match, so all he's doing is just wearing down Iroquois. Oh. Here we go. And he tags in the Monster. See if the Monster's gonna live up to his name, and wait a minute. The Wolf wisely getting out of the way. And throws him into the corner. It's gonna happen here. Tags in Iroquois. Bounces him against the ropes. Oh! Great tag team maneuver right there. DDT. Tags in Dokes. The big man's now in. Oh. I back. Elbow right to the face. What is this? It throws him right back in the ring. Looks like Dokes is just now toying with Iroquois. Wait a minute. Ghost throws him right back into the ring. What's going to happen here? Iroquois throws him right outside. The Ghost and the Wolf are now fighting on the outside. Oh! The big man at the mercy of Iroquois. What's going to happen here? Ref is counting. Wait a minute! Oh! And because of that, Dokes has been eliminated. Wolf is all by himself and a drop kick. Perfect opportunity here for Dawn of Destruction and Iroquois to get a decisive win over the Wolfpack Legion. It will be the first time since they have fought against each other. Suplex. Stomping him down. Wolf now starting to fight back, realizing that he is all alone. He's gonna have to try everything he can to just survive here. I think even the Wolfpack Legion knows that they can't win them all. Oh man, now Wolf's just working on the shoulders of Iroquois, slowing him down. DDT! Wolf right now is just playing some mind games with Iroquois without trying to get a rest, maybe a little bit of both. And throws him against the turnbuckle. Iroquois with a dropkick, beautiful dropkick. Tags in the monster. Now the monster's in to do some damage to the wolf. Wolf goes outside the ring. Oh, monster just pushes him down and gets thrown right back in the ring. Wolf probably does not like his chances. I mean, this has turned into a 3-on-1 handicap match. Wait a minute, out of nowhere, the Howling Moon! The Howling Moon out of nowhere, and now it is down to the Wolf, Iroquois, and the Ghost, and a crossbody. And Russian leg sweep. Just can't believe it, out of nowhere with the Howling Moon. Wait a minute. And Iroquois stops the Wolf just in the nick of time. What's gonna happen here? Looks like he's a little dazed and confused. He tags him in. Oh man. Big time clothesline. So far, looks like the Wolf's in control of the two-time tag team champion, the Ghost. Oh, clothesline. Man, just slamming his head right down to the mat. Oh, spinning back fist from the Ghost. Oh. Wait a minute, what is the Ghost gonna do here? He's up top. Oh, springboard elbow drop. Trying to go for a knee. Oh, clothesline from the Wolf. Vicious punches from the two of them. Come over, kicks him outside the ring. I think the Ghost at this point needs to try to adopt a new strategy, because right now, oh, the NGWF veteran, the Wolf, is just systematically dominating the Ghost at this point. Oh, kicks him right in the gut, and another Howling Moon. We are now down to Iroquois and the Wolf in this exciting main event match. The two leaders, oh, of the respective ally, the leader of the Wolfpack Legion, the Wolf, and Iroquois, who's basically helping DOD get their revenge on the Wolfpack Legion. These two are now... Oh, these two are all that's left. Who is gonna come out of this match? Wait a minute! Here we go! The torture act that Iroquois has beaten the Wolf! And because of that, Iroquois and Dawn of Destruction win this main event. But can they do this at Winter Wonderball? Can they beat the Wolfpack Legion when so much is on the line? Can they beat them with the tag team titles and the NGWF World Championship on the line? Can they beat them when the loser of that match will be forced to disband forever. Can they do it? I don't know. We'll just have to see on the 25th of this month. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank you for tuning in to this episode of Drop Zone. I will see you next week.